So now open your Chrome again and try to open the URL, and it will be opening your application here. So this is a simple way for you to open a deep link in your application, as our application is already installed in our mobile, so it is automatically opening our application. And if it is not installed, and if our application is present in Play Store, it will be redirecting to Play Store, and from there it will ask you to download it and install it. In this vlog, we will try to see the concept of deep linking in Flutter application. So what is a deep linking and why do we use it? So whenever you try to open an application, you will tap on the icon and you will open the application, and you will move to the required screens based upon your app services. So what if you want to make the app open and automatically redirect to a particular page, and you want to send this, you want to share this page with your friend, and whenever your friend tap on that particular link, the application, if not installed, should go to Play Store and install the application. And when once the application is installed, when you tap on that particular link, the exact page needs to be opened. For example, in your application, you are having 5 screens like profile, settings, about, help. So I just want to open the help screen, and the user may not aware where the help screen is exactly. So with the help of a link, you can directly open the help screen. And also a real-time example, like in Amazon or Flipkart, whenever you are having a particular product you have searched and you want to share that particular product with your friend, so he need not search again from all the available products, right? You can just share the product there, and whenever he tries to open the link in his mobile, then there will be an option like whether you want to open a browser or you want to open in the particular application. So whenever you tap on the application, your Amazon application will be opened up and will be directly redirected to that particular product page instead of showing home page and all the other options. So I think you know understood what is a deep link. So follow this tutorial till the end. Why? Because this will be the very easier concept for you to understand when you follow this tutorial. And in this particular tutorial, we will be seeing in an easier way how a deep link works and how we can create it using a Firebase. So now let's get started. The first thing is we need to open the Firebase console here. I have created a project like deep link. For creating a project, you can just tap on the add project here and you can specify your project name. And after specifying your project name, here I will be showing you with the help of my project. So here I have already added an Android project. So whenever you have specified a name there, then it will be asking you this particular screen here. So this particular screen will be visible whenever you have provided the project name, and here you need to provide the package name here. In the Flutter project directory here, you can close it and open it now. Here you can see Android, and inside Android there is an app directory, and inside the app there is source directory, inside the source main directory, and inside which you are having an Android manifest file here. So you can just copy this package name. So this is just a display name. You can provide whatever name you require. So here you need to provide Shavan. For now I'm just skipping it, and if your project requires it, you may provide it there. And if you want to know how we can generate Shavan, I have done a tutorial. I will be sharing the link in the description section below. And then you need to download the JSON file here. So whenever you provide these details here, here you can see I have created a project already with this particular package name which you have seen earlier, so it is not allowing me again with the same package name. So to show you now, I'm just adding one more word here, and here you need to provide some name. And when you tap on the register app button here, it will take some time and it will provide you the JSON file now. So download this particular JSON file and you need to add it under the app directory here. Here you can see this is my Google services JSON file, and you need to add this particular file. And now follow the further steps here. So when you tap on next here, it will show you the procedure to add Firebase to your project. So just copy this particular line, and here it is showing you paste this particular, add this particular line in build.gradle here. So inside the app folder, here you are having a file build.gradle, and here you need to add the dependency here. And later on you need to go to this particular build.gradle and you need to add Google services here. Just make sure you add these two particular things here, and you can also select Kotlin or Java, and then you need to tap on next here. So I'm not going to create a project now because I'm already having a deep link here. Here we have created a deep link, and now let's try to move down here. You can see dynamic links over here. So whenever you tap on this particular screen for the first time, you will be getting a screen where there is an option called get started. Tap on that particular button, get started, and you will be getting this particular screen. So as I have already created a dynamic link here, you can see it is showing me that particular link here, and you can also add your own link. If you are not having any host address, you can just make use of your project name .page.link here. So here you can see new dynamic link I am trying to create. Start I am providing here, and tap on the next button. So here I am going to provide my URL like https://google.com, and here I am just trying to name it like Google. And here what needs to be done when you open this particular link in an iOS device. So in the coming tutorial, we will be seeing how we can handle a dynamic link in iOS application. So for now, I'm just trying to open it in our browser itself. So tap on the next button. And in this tutorial, we are seeing deep link behavior in Android application. Tap on this particular thing and select the application. So this is a deep link. So previously we have added our application, right? There I have specified, you can specify your own project name. Project name will be appearing here, select that one. If your application is not installed on the user device, for example, as we have discussed, whenever you have shared an Amazon link to your friend, if Amazon application is not installed on their device, so it will ask you to install the application first. It will directly redirect to the Google Play Store, and there it will open to the Amazon application and it will ask you to install. Or else you can just open a custom URL here as we have specified above our google.com, but we want to open it in our application only. If application is not installed, it will be going to the Play Store page and it will ask you to download the application, and then only it will open. So now tap on the next button here, and here you can see this is a social media tags. For example, whenever you copy a particular link from YouTube or any other website and you try to share it with your friends on WhatsApp, and whenever you paste the link in the chat box, you can see some more data is being added to your message, like what is the link about, title, description, and all those things will be coming up, right? So here this is that particular section, and this is again completely optional. You may add or you may not add, it's your wish again. So I'm just going to create a dynamic link now. Our link is being now created. So here this is our link which we have created just now, and you can just copy this particular link, and this is our application. Currently we don't have anything in our application other than the details which we have entered right into our build and manifest. Also we need to add some more information. So now let's try to see what needs to be done on Flutter side. So here it is asking us to add the intent filter now. So this is some information here we need to add in our Android manifest file. So just copy this particular code and get back to our manifest file. Here I have already added this. Here you can see the deep linking. So you need to add it inside the activity itself. So this is our activity. We are having only one activity now. So this is an open tag and this is a closed tag. And before to the closed tag, you need to add this particular data such that it gets considered. And again, we are having only one activity, so I have specified here. So if you are having multiple activities, you can just specify. But coming to the Flutter application, we will be having only one activity. So just follow this scenario only. Whenever you are dealing with your Android native application, there you might have multiple activities, and based on the activity, you can specify there. And one more thing you need to consider here, you need to add your host here. So Flutter deeplinks.page.link. So this is our host here, if you observe. So this particular host, you need to make sure you add it exactly as it is displayed here. Even if there is one word difference, our application will not be opened up whenever you try to open it through the link. And here you need to provide the schema like HTTPS and HTTP, both we are providing here. So sometimes some host may support only HTTP and some may support HTTPS. And coming to our Flutter code here, we have not specified much coding here. So it's just a basic stateless widget and taken up a container which is in the center of the screen, and inside which we are having only a text widget. So this is what you have seen. And now let's try to copy our code here. And once you have done all these changes, just make sure you rerun the code again such that all the changes which you have done in the code, like manifest and build.gradle, all the things, and Google services JSON, all this reflect in your application. So now open your Chrome again and try to open the URL, and it will be opening your application here. So this is a simple way for you to open a deep link in your application. As our application is already installed in our mobile, so it is automatically opening our application. And if it is not installed, and if our application is present in Play Store, it will be redirecting to Play Store, and from there it will ask you to download it and install it. So in our coming tutorials, we will be seeing how we can make use of the data which we have provided into a dynamic link. For example, you have provided a promo code, you have provided some coupon codes. Whenever your friend install that particular application, and you might get some benefit. So in that way, when we will see how we can share that particular data. And so to make sure this tutorial easily understandable, I have not provided any extra code in our Flutter application. I just want to open the app whenever you tap on the link, that's all. So we have achieved that. If you are having any queries in this particular tutorial, do let me know in the comment section below. And there are a few more tutorials in our channel based upon Flutter, so you may go through them. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.